Hello everybody, this is Buck WSR Weezer coming at you today with a small engine repair project. You can see in front of you today we're looking at a Troy built 25cc backpack blower. It's model TB25BP and I currently have it disassembled, as you can see here, all over my desk. And the project that I'm working on today is to create a new cylinder gasket. Here's the cylinder head, which I've removed from the machine. The reason for that was to deal with a loss of compression and some carbon buildup around the piston rings. I'll maybe show you that in a future video. But what I have to do is create a new gasket, new cylinder gasket. Now I looked up the part number and it was, you see there at the bottom, cylinder gasket MC-9014-MD1505. I could not find it anywhere, it's just not available. So I decided to make my own gasket and I bought a roll of high temperature gasket material. Now this stuff is a 16th of an inch thick. I've cut a piece off right here. It actually appears to be a little bit thicker than what is on here, but I'm gonna go with it anyway because that's what I have. So here's my strategy, here's my plan. I'm gonna try to remove the you see how the other one broke, this section broke off. And so as I can't replace this gasket, I'm going to make a new one out of this material. So my first step is going to be with this scraper to hopefully, no, boy, that's going to be tough to get off. I may go get a razor blade that might help me get under there. This putty knife is probably a little too thick. I want to try to get off as much as of it as I can intact and then be able to trace it onto this piece of gasket material. Because beyond that, I don't really have a way of coming up with a gasket to put this engine back together. So, let's see if I'm able to remove this old gasket. Without destroying it too terribly badly. So that I can then trace out a new one. Alright, so far so good here now that I'm using this razor blade. How's that looking? Not too terrible. I will have to clean all this other stuff, residue off of the cylinder head before we install the new one. Alright, so now we've got the old gasket and the new piece of gasket material. And I've got this fine point pin that I'm hoping will work. And I'm going to try to trace out what we have here. I don't think this pen's actually writing, so I'm gonna go look for another. Locating a fine tip pen has thus far proved to be the most challenging part of this project. I'm gonna try this ballpoint pen, though I'm not too thrilled with that idea. It does seem to work though. Obviously, it's the tracing out the inner part of the gasket so that it corresponds to the opening of the cylinder. That's the most important part here. The difficulty is I'm left-handed, which means I'm putting my hand in front of your line of sight. All right, let me try this. The pen seems to be working pretty good now. And when I cut this out with an X-Acto knife or a fine point razor blade, I'm gonna opt to cut towards the outside of these lines on the inner ring. The inner circle. Only two cylinder head bolts on this particular engine. Okay, well, I think I've traced out so far what I've got, and of course the part I don't have traced is the part that's missing. And I'm going to have to try to figure out how to trace that out as well. Now, if I look at the cylinder head, okay, which goes on like that, it also goes on like that. Which means it appears that the inner part is mostly symmetrical. So what I could do is take this. We had it, how did we have this? We had it like this. I could probably flip it over and this part would match up fairly closely. With that part of the gasket that's currently missing. Let's just try it. What's the worst that could happen? You could screw up. And I could start over. After all, I did buy an entire roll of this stuff. All right, so there we go. Now I want to try to find a razor that's pretty sharp. Now I'm going to use something like this. And this is the kind of thing where, but I've used this a lot, where you can break it off a piece at a time. So I'm going to try to break it off and get it down to where we have a sharper part of the blade. Let's go ahead and see if we can cut this out. I'm going to try to cut right to the outside of my mark. Blade seems sharp enough. Kind of nice working here on a desk with a glass top because I know I'm not going to scratch it. And it also provides a nice firm surface to work on here. So that's starting to separate there. And a pause because you don't need to watching me do this whole thing, and I'll show you the final product when I'm done. Okay, I cut out the inner part, and I brought up the cylinder head to fit it on top. And it'll actually be like this. And I think that fits pretty good. What I also did was I took the blade and just cut all along here with the new gasket in place. Trimmed off a little bit of excess that was bending down. Okay, so I feel pretty good about that. Now I just got to cut out the spot for the bolt holes and then the outside. And then we'll have our new gasket. So what I'm going to do to drill out to make these holes is I'm going to use a drill bit and a drill with a block of wood beneath it to drill out those holes. So I'm going with a 3/16 drill bit, which seems to be about the size of the holes in the old gasket. So let's give that a shot. And this project will be done. One. There's two. Here's our cylinder head. New gasket fits over that. So here we have it. Old broken gasket. We made a new one. Now we can reassemble our engine and bring it back into business. Buck WSR Weezer, I thank you for watching this video. Invite your comments and questions. Now you see how you can make your own gaskets when you need to. Thank you for watching. I encourage you to subscribe to my channel for other small engine projects and things that I'm interested in that you probably are too. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.